lot of great work is underpinned by a great thought to begin with, or a great point of view on the world that hasn't been articulated fully yet. I certainly believe that a strategic underpinning behind a film makes a film better. A certain story, a certain point that's being made, if that point resonates, then the film might have a better chance of resonating.
I think the only criteria I'm looking for is emotion. Whatever the emotion is. Does it make me sing? Does it make me cry? Does it make me laugh? Does it make me get pissed? I want to feel something in the first 5 seconds of commercial. And then the commercial got me. And then if it's mad enough and well executed, then I love it.
You see, my friends, with every brace and every conflict, we say, I am the master of my fate.
What I was looking for was the more the interactive films. I think that's a really cool category. I think that those projects always jump out because of the interesting storytelling, you know, narrative. The reason I loved Assassin's Creed so much was they incorporated the user, so the user first had to, you know, make their own avatar, and then they incorporate that in this big, you know, CGI film. And then later on, they could actually check in the film where their avatar was placed.
Tonight, as we stand on the edge of possibility, we choose the path less trodden.
You don't need an amazing craft to have an amazing film, but then craft is just, it opened doors of different type of execution, I think. But execution will never replace a great idea. So first, have a great idea, then obviously use all the technique you can get to make it look as beautiful as possible.
Are there ideas left? There are always ideas left. I think it's always our job to try to find new, fresh ideas. Certainly some things feel familiar, and that's not necessarily a bad thing when you're trying to tell a certain story. But our job is to keep on looking for what's new.
Everything you ever dreamed.